Hi, welcome back to CS170. I'm going to continue on with our discussion with arrays for week 8. Let's see here. Yeah, so we left off with the weekdays here. So what we're going to cover today is just a couple more different things to define arrays and how we can work with arrays. And I'm going to actually just include one more thing in there. And then we also do a couple calls to functions. So that should be useful. That's something we covered in the past, but just give you more example. So here we have an example where we're going to declare an array. And the main point really here is that, you see, normally you go like 0 to whatever. In this case, there's a new array. Note the capital A. We have 7 elements in the array, and we're going to reference them in different ways. And all this is really saying is that you can do whatever in here. As long as it evaluates to a number, it's valid, right? So here you have 0, 1, do equals to 2, right? Now note this, we did the variable, we initialized it to a number, that's 2. If this was a string, again, we have a problem, which I've mentioned in past lectures. So this is a 2, 2 plus 1, again, you're working with this as a number, 2 plus 1, 2 times 2, 3 times 2 minus 1, and so forth, right? The main point here that they're trying to say is that you get this to evaluate to a number, then you can reference this in the array element, okay? And I actually just quickly put this into js.do to run it. And let me just clear out all of these guys here because I'm going to talk about this. Okay, forget it. I just leave it for now. What the heck? Maybe I'm here. I'll just do it. So script, just not to break this up a little bit. So let me take this out. And so you look at this. This is basically this whole thing here. And then I just created like a little for loop. So I equals to 0. I created the I up here. I equals to 0. I is less than 7. That's the check. I plus plus to iterate. And we're just doing an alert. So let's see. This should work. Happy, sleepy, dopey, sneezy, bashful, grumpy, doc. And you're done. Right, so I just went through this whole array with this for loop, and you can see all these got assigned properly, so you're good. Okay, so hopefully that was a quick little thing just to show you how you can reference the elements in the array. Okay, let me put this back to here, and let me take this out as we talk to the next section here. Okay. So one thing I wanted to put in here, it's not actually part of the arrays lecture, but it just came up as a question on one of the quiz. So we talked about how we set something to be a number, right? So you can see in this case, you have a var, test number, and we're taking in these things, basically strings, and we're making it to a number, right? So this could be something where, you know, you have a text box, like you remember from the HTML, and somehow you got something in strings. But really you want to treat it to be numbers. So you can't play around with it as a number when it's defined as a string. And so what happens here, this number is taking the result of this and making it into a number. So I think a lot of people were doing something like this where they were taking 4555 plus 23 to make a number. And they're adding it as two numbers and then applying this and then saying divide by 1,000, right? But if you can really do that, then you don't need to set this number here. So really, this being on outside, this is being treated as strings. So these are being concatenated together, okay? So if I run this very quickly, so you can see 234.555. which is what this would be if you concatenate these two things together into one big number and then divide it by 1,000. Okay, so something to be careful with, so just understand what this means. There's a difference between taking these two and concatenating them versus adding them together like numbers like you would expect. Okay. So that was just a quick thing that came up in the quiz. So I'm going to take that out. Now let's come back to here. Okay, I'm just going to talk this one through. So here we're doing another array, so math answers. And I don't know if I mentioned this before, but you guys might notice when we do these variables, you have like something where you say the word and then the next word starts off with a capital. This is what they refer to as camel case. As you can imagine, like it kind of looks like a camel, right? Depending on how many of these capitals you put in here. But that's a convention you follow to name variables. There's other types of conventions we can go by. I don't think it really matters for this class, but in case some people were curious. New, and again, I'll highlight this again, array with a capital A here, and four. Okay, so that means there's four elements in this array for math answers. So for the variable I equals to 0, I is less than math answers.length, right? Remember, starting off at 0, I plus plus, right? And as it loops through each time, it's going to basically assign I times 3, right? So whatever this I happens to be, as it loops through I times 3, then it's going to do an alert for that. It's also going to do a document write, okay, which is essentially writing as if you were trying to do HTML, okay? So it's doing both of these. So in the assignment 6, you guys were doing stuff with alerts in terms of pop-ups from JavaScript. Now you're also doing it with the HTML, writing it out, okay? So here the pop-up would say 0369, and on the page would also display 0369. Okay, so I think there's a kind of a way that you can see how you're displaying an output in different ways, either in pop-up box or on the HTML page. Okay, so you can play around with this on your own if you like. The next thing is, here's a different way of populating or initializing an array with values. Okay, so now we declared people as an array. And then we do same thing here, new array. But now instead of saying we're going to have however many elements, I can't see how many names we have. Looks like we have 7 names. We're going to just pop in these names and list them like this. Same thing if you want to create an array of numbers, right? Obviously without the double quotes. So Joe, Mary, Tom. And so this would correspond to 0, to 1, to 2, to 3, so on and so forth. And then here, this is a for loop that basically loops through like you did before. I equals to 0, I is less than people.length, I plus plus, and now we're writing it out on the HTML page, okay? And I actually did that over here. So we ran it, and you see Joe, Mary, Tom, Eliza. So I got lazy, I only put in 4 names here, but you get the idea, right? So you get these 4 guys here, then the for loop, and then you do the document write. And this is HTML, so you do a BR at the end, and this is what you get here on the right-hand side, right? That's what this is, okay? So you should try to understand the different ways to create arrays or initialize arrays. So this is one of them, so pay attention to this one. Now here, we have the same thing here, and we have the same thing here, so this is fine. This part here talks about just combining some of the stuff we've learned in the past. This one is we created a function, pick random num, and then the range, and then we create a variable called rand, and then we do a math.floor, which is going to take a math.random times range, right? And then does a floor on that, and then returns a random number, right? So what the outcome of this is, I don't know if I mentioned in a previous lecture, but basically the random number is between 0 and 1, right? So it could be point, whatever, right? And so that's why when you do a multiplier, a range is basically saying, okay, you don't want all your random numbers between 0 and 1. It's probably like 10, 20, 30, whatever number you want. And that's what that range is when you come in here, right? So you multiply by the range, and you get a random number multiplied by that 0 to 1, what the math.random returns. Okay, so that's why you do something like this. It's basically multiplying out so you can make the range to really the range that you want, not just always between 0 and 1. Okay, and then the math.floor just essentially takes out the decimal part of it takes it to the bottom, rounds it down. Okay, and then it does return of a random. Okay, and so what this is doing is, in this case, you're basically taking the size of the array. So this is the people.length. Okay, and you know, when I put in here, so let's say you actually wanted to be able to get a zero or whatever, right? And that's where the math.floor will come in. You know, so it will take anything between 0 and 1 and take it down to 0, right? And, you know, similar on the other end, let's say I passed in the range, in this case was a range of 7, right? You having a number 7 is not going to be valid. So you get anywhere between 6 and 7, it's going to round it down to 6, which is what you want, okay? So that's why this math.floor is important. So here you pick random num, you pass the size of the array in here, come up with a random number, which essentially comes back with a element in the array. It could be anywhere from 0 to 6. And then you put it in here, and then when you read it, that's what comes out, right? So this is what I did here. And let's see here. Actually, let me come over to here for a second. Right, so this is not an alert box, right? And this is how we got to it, right? So this is an interesting thing for you to know, right? This is, we're coming back towards mixing in the array, the HTML with the JavaScript. So you might recognize the on click because of the button, right? So we created the button. This is all HTML here. And you did the on click. And there were some JavaScript within this on click here, which can access the variables or functions that I defined in the script section, right? And this is a new thing probably for most of you. You see this, basically we created this P, right? These tags here, and then we created the ID person, okay? So this is where you get this document element by ID, which is person, dot inner HTML, right? You don't really need to understand like what all this means. All you have to know is that this is what you use to access from the JavaScript within this onClick. You know, before, you remember onClick, you had a text box and you would set the text box dot value equal to whatever you want to put in there. This is a case where you create this ID with this P tag, and you reference it like this, right? And then you populate the information in, right? Here's the lucky one here based on this variable here, okay? So this is something you should take notes on. This is something you should probably try on your own and make sure you reference this technique in case this question comes up the exam. This is important for you to know, okay? And the code is right here, so just take it off of here later on when you get a chance. But I implemented the code here. So notice this, right? If you're doing the HTML page, you have a script section, maybe it's in the head or whatever. And then once you get past the script, then here's my HTML. So button ID, all of this, which matches up to here. And then you have the choose button, which is this, right? That's the text here. And then you have this tag, ID equals the person. And then you access it by this dot inner HTML equals to this. Okay, and let's run it. I listed this up here. Then I hit the choose button and it says, and the lucky person is Mary, which is basically taking this part here and sticking it in here. Okay, so I hope that's clear. You might want to repeat this, you might want to write it down yourself, or you might want to try it out with your own editor. Try this out, this is important. You're going to definitely get some reference to this on how you take the JavaScript output and apply something like this, right, .innerHTML to print this out. Okay, so I'm gonna hold that for a second. Let's see what this last page is. Okay, so this is something for extra credit. Okay, so this is my last extra credit bit for this week. So go ahead, read through this problem, and basically it's working with arrays, right? This is a good way for you to practice array. Yeah, there's a little bit of a typo here. Just fix that guy there. And just run through it, try to model it off of what I kind of did here, where I created a function, how I did some stuff with the array. Hopefully a lot of stuff I talked about in the lecture you can apply to this, and this is for you to practice, okay? And if you can show me the code, send me a screenshot of your output, that'll be good for extra credit for this week, okay? And that's it for arrays for this week. Give me a shout if there's any questions. Thank you.